Here from Windows Central. Tonight I'm joined on the mic by Brian and RoyalBob.
Howdy.
Hello.
And tonight's stream is unique in that we are streaming several Xbox 360 titles that are backwards compatible on Xbox One. The idea is that these games are included when you buy Rare Replay, the collection that comes out on Tuesday. But if you already own them on Xbox 360 and you're in the preview program, then you can play them right now anyway.
You can play most of them, but not all of them are available.
So Perfect Dark is available, right, Bob? You would tell me if I was playing a game that wasn't.
I'm pretty sure it is available. Yeah, I checked the list. I'm pretty sure these ones are available.
Because we're trying to respect the embargo here.
Yeah, I'll double check, but I'm pretty sure this one's available.
So we're going to be a little more informal with tonight's stream. You know, we've got QuakeCon to talk about, Tyler's absence, so-called gamer, a bunch of different little subjects. And I'll give you guys an update on Quiplash. That is that we had planned to do Quiplash tonight. Two reasons why we didn't. One is that my review for the Rare Replay is due on Monday, so I wanted to get a look at how these games run, and I just don't have a lot of time because unfortunately I'm working every night. Then the other thing is that the prizes we were promised on Quiplash did not come through in time, even though we were promised them. Some behind the scenes things going on there. So hopefully we can do Quiplash next week. If all goes well, right?
Yep. That'd be awesome.
Yeah, I hope so. I really wanted to play it tonight, but then again, I am also excited to see these games from Rare. It's been a while since I played one of their games. Ooh, look at that. Sign in. So I have to manually sign in. This is my first time actually playing a backwards compatible game on my Xbox One.
I've tried a few. They seem to work all right.
Yeah, they seem really good.
Eurogamer wasn't crazy about Mass Effect's performance. Do you remember that, you guys?
I saw it. I did not have a similar experience playing Mass Effect.
Yeah, that's interesting. And other people have said good things too, so I'm not sure. They got me scared though, I can tell you that. Control style, let's see, classic, Spartan, or duty calls? I guess I would want to go with Spartan, wouldn't I? Then again, it could actually tell you what the buttons do, couldn't it? And it doesn't. So you're picking these styles and you're like, oh, hope for the best. But then here's advanced control. Southpaw, legacy. Is one of those invert, like look invert? Because, you know, Tyler, he would just go crazy playing a game the normal way.
I don't understand that.
Yeah, it's like, you know, when everyone learns to play games, why would you pick like an alternate option and just decide to learn that way? You know, like just learn the normal way. That way you can avoid problems later on in life. But many of our audience here probably made the same decision as him. Show mission time, why not? There's a paintball option too. Does that mean like instead of blood it looks like paint?
Like
yeah,
neon green,
like your
or something?
Bullet will be like paintball.
Nice option. Yeah, this was originally published by Nintendo on the Nintendo 64, so I could see why they would have less violent stuff going on. Or less violent options. And this was sort of the sequel to GoldenEye, wasn't it, you guys?
Yep, I was just about to mention that. Even some of the game's code has a lot of is taken from GoldenEye.
That is wild. And here we are. I'm moving around. I don't have a weapon yet, I guess. Can I do anything with that computer?
Hey, So-Called.
Oh. So-Called, good to see you. I thought you were at work, So-Called. Otherwise, I would have tried to get you on mic.
He might still be.
Alright, I do not know what to do. This is before they believed in tutorials.
Well, there's tutorials, like, I think you're in the tutorial area right now, where you just kind of walk around and do
but
whatever you want.
I don't know how to open the door. Oh, there we go. I think it might have been A. It's good to see you. Oh, here's a dude. Didn't they improve the graphics a little bit? Because the models seem alright.
I think they fixed the frame rate issues that the original had, but I don't know if they changed the models.
Yeah, frame rate does seem pretty smooth.
The original's kind of unplayable now.
Can't figure out how to jump. Yeah, I always found N64 games unbearably ugly, so Tyler doesn't like when I say that, but they were pretty heinous to look at when they were in 3D, which was most of them.
Well, that's because they had terrible textures.
Yes, exactly. And
they didn't have enough RAM to stick large.
And it would just blur the crap out of everything, right? So everything looked like a smeared mess. And then you usually didn't have a good frame rate either, or often anyway. Press A next to a terminal to use it. Okay. There was a tutorial message. I'm pushing A next to things. She seems like a nice lady. She looks like a little bit like Firuza Balk, actually. I mean, not her alien-looking arms, but her face. Tells me push A next to a terminal to use it, and then I'm walking next to all the computers, and pushing A is not doing anything. Now, I can play Ocarina of Time. Like, as a game, I like it all right, but I do not like how it looks. Like, 3D was not ready to go prime time yet at that point, in my opinion. Boy, I've just about had enough of Perfect Dark already.
Man, we're only like 5 minutes in here. Jeez.
Yeah, maybe we should do some of the missions instead of tutorial.
That's a good idea. Return to main menu. Fine. By the way, this game took quite a while to start up when I launched it. It probably took about 5 minutes to actually start up due to the Xbox 360 emulation. I don't know why it would work that way.
That's how long it takes my Xbox 360 to start up, so it seems right.
Clean that hard drive off.
Three difficulties, agent, special, and perfect. Gain entrance to laboratory. Sure, why not? By the way, you guys, I was out of town last week for QuakeCon, as many of you will know. And Brian and Bob here were good enough to keep the ship going for me while I was gone.
Yeah, we try not to sink it.
Thanks for that, dudes. Yes, the game is on an external drive. I don't think it was a matter of normal loading this long startup time. I think it was more like trying to pull my save from the cloud when I didn't have one or something. I don't know, but it really took a while, and we'll see that if I switch games, which I am planning to do.
That could be a cloud.
Yeah, that's very likely. My Windows 10 dropped 4 days ago. So their servers are probably a little overwhelmed.
I can imagine. And even Xbox Live was down for a while, wasn't it, a couple days ago?
Yeah, right when Windows 10 came out, Xbox Live kind of took a dive.
Thanks, trolls. Is it wrong that I hope that, the people who do the DDoS attacks and stuff die?
Might be a little extreme, but
they're not going to anything to society. Like the guy who got busted in the Netherlands or whatever, he'd done like a million, called in a bomb threat and all that crap.
Well, that's just stupid.
They're nasty people who have to spread their nastiness, and no one will ever mate with them. No one will ever love them. So there's just no jumping, is that it? Feels weird not being able to jump. Ah! Hey!
Keep in mind, this is, like an 8 or 9 year old first-person shooter.
Yeah, before jumping was invented.
Well, before it was popular, anyway.
Why can't I switch weapons? Holding X brings up this, looks like a weapon menu. Then it doesn't let me actually switch to them. I push down and maybe I'm out of bullets?
If it's red, I believe that means you don't have any ammo. Okay.
Well, that sucks. Alright, A does open doors and stuff, so at least I'm clear on that. Ow!
Might have done these in the wrong order, but they'll get the idea.
This whole getting shot and not having a gun thing. Picked up some ammo, now can I switch to a gun?
Yeah, it's kind of a stealthy game.
Still can't switch to them. ECM mine needed to disable security hub. Well, I wish I had an ECM mine. this is one of those games when they announced it was coming to XBLA, you know, back in the day, I think people were excited about it, but we... What just happened? I now do have a gun, however the light is out.
Yes, you press the light switch.
Why would that even be an option, dude? I have no idea where that light switch is.
It's a stealth game.
This is awful.
Yeah,
it's so awful. How did you guys ever enjoy this?
Oh man, how did we ever play these games?
That was enough. So that was perfect dark, you guys. It's a darkness simulator. Very black. I give the blackness a 10 out of 10.
I guess they got that right.
Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I try not to judge older games by modern standards or anything, but, I mean, why would that even be a thing you could do? And stealth is not a good enough option. You have to be able to see somehow.
Well, yeah, you used night vision.
What night vision? You didn't say anything about that. Probably would have taken 20 minutes to get to it.
Yeah, I don't remember the controls of the game, so...
So, what should our next game be?
Viva Pinata.
Oh, man, that's going to be too time-consuming.
It is awesome. It's so fun, though.
It's such a good game.
I think we'll switch to Jetpac Refuelled, because it's real quick. And I definitely wanted to play Kameo, too, but Jetpac will go by in a few minutes.
We can always have a fashion show in Viva Pinata, too. But my cluckles are better than your pinatas.
Well, let me switch to the name of the game on Twitch. It's going to be just a second, you guys. Yeah, no, GoldenEye, I did have a lot of fun playing it in multiplayer with friends. I don't know if I ever messed with the campaign at all, because I didn't own an N64, because like I said, I didn't like the games very much.
Yeah, I didn't own one either. I had a PS1.
Do you know, I didn't get a PS1 until way later. I was a Sega Saturn dude through and through.
I bought a Sega Saturn for like $35 at the used, you know, the local used game store where I grew up, and bought like two games on it, and then never played it again.
Oh, that's a shame, dude. It had a brilliant library.
Yeah, but by the time I got one, you know, this was well into the PS2 generation, so it was hard to find stuff.
I can imagine. I still have a pretty good collection going for that. I never parted ways with those. So now we've relaunched it. You can see it's emulating the Xbox 360, or at least it's doing the startup animation for it.
So what game are we starting?
Yes,
Jetpac?
Jetpac Refuelled, which was a very early XBLA game, like one of the earliest, like a first year release, I think. Not launch, but still pretty early. Nice to see. This was back when they were still using Rare in a decent way, or at least the Rare name. Because, yeah, it's a sequel to older, more obscure game from Rare. And it is pretty archaic in some ways.
Well, it was before all the Rare leadership jumped ship and started Playtonic.
There you go. So there... Yeah, there's an online multiplayer mode. Oh, it's local also. It's been a while. I tried really hard to get every achievement in this. It's a little too hard for, I would say, for most normal humans to. I think I might have even, you know, like, been on my Adderall at some point and still couldn't do it. Yeah, because sometimes I take that and sometimes I don't. But it does help with concentration and makes you think a little faster. Ooh.
Well, didn't the eSports League, Major League Gaming, just say they're going to start testing all their people for Adderall
usage?
If you have
a prescription, then I don't see what they could do about it. That's not fair. But
well, yeah, but most of them don't.
Yeah, I can imagine. In that case, it would be bad. And, you know, it is one of those drugs that they regulate very strictly.
Yeah, yeah. There's a lot of heavy abuse in universities.
So here's a nice thing. It does remember what levels I've gotten to. It's a really long game, 125 levels. It might even go up to 130. I think you just get a checkpoint every 5 levels. We're just going to start right at the beginning. We'll see what it looks like. Real European art style. It looks like that one game started with an A that came out on PlayStation and Xbox One a few months ago. Do you remember what that game was? God. Tyler streamed it one time.
Yeah, I know the one you're talking about. I just can't think of
it. It was really, really yellow.
Oh. I was hoping somebody in the Windows Central chat saw that I started the contest.
Oh, did they?
Well, I've got a couple entries here now. The, you know, looks like people weren't paying attention really well.
I'm remembering this fondly now. Yeah, this game is actually, like I said, it gets too hard. You know, it goes on really long and they crank the difficulty. But it is quite a lot of fun. Like, you fly with right trigger, you know, and you just let go of it and you sink back down to the ground. So that's a pretty intuitive control scheme. And there's a lot of different weapons and stuff you can get. They spawn throughout the level. I think I'm trying to collect parts to my ship or something. God. Bob, you don't remember what that game is? It looks a little bit like Dust and that other game that was Dust-like that also... I'm not able to remember anything tonight. Wow.
I know what you're... I think... Is it the one that kind of looks like Ori?
Yes,
but
yes. Looks like Ori, but not as good.
Yeah, I don't remember what it's called.
Anyway, you can see that kind of European comic book style art, like for the backgrounds at least, very flat, but colorful.
Oops, somebody needs to mute their phone.
Sorry, God.
Bad Paul, jeez.
Sometimes I wonder whether I should keep... what I have is Twitter notifications enabled for Cheap-Ass Gamer. You know, so I get notifications of the deals, but then, like, they do so many tweets throughout the day, and it, you know, it becomes very noisy sometimes. It's the only Twitter channel that I have, you know, phone notifications turned on for.
I just turn them all off.
Yeah, so I'm collecting fuel and bringing it back to my ship. That's what I'm doing. But you know, the one achievement I wasn't able to get doesn't even involve this regular mode here. It actually involves the classic, because this includes the original Jetpac game. And the original Jetpac game is, you know, crap. But it's super, super hard because enemies can just spawn, like, right around you, or I can't remember, they might even spawn on top of you, but basically they can spawn anywhere. So your death, you know, like, it's almost random whether you die or not. You know, like, the element of luck is too great.
Well, that doesn't sound like fun.
And, you know, being an older game, it also, you know, looks like butt because it's an old computer game. But we'll see it in a minute. Play a couple more levels of this. Neither of you guys ever played this one?
Nope.
Yeah, it's been largely forgotten. But for, you know, for an early XBLA title, especially back when they had a 50 megabyte limit, so they all had to be tiny, I think it packed a really nice amount of fun into, you know, the download and everything. It must have been a $5 or $10 game. Because back then it was unusual for anything to be 15.
Ah, the good old days when games were cheap.
They were. But, you know, they've increased in scope so much. I saw somebody on NeoGAF complaining about the price for Toy Soldiers 3, which comes out in 2 weeks, I think.
How much
is
that?
Well, the default game is $15, and you get, like, four armies to work with, and they're original armies, you know? So it's basically just the normal Toy Soldiers sequel experience at $15. But for $30, you get the licensed armies, which include Masters of the Universe, G.I. Joe, Cobra, and Assassin's Creed. So, like, if you want the, you know, if you want to think of it as a full experience deal, then you're going to want the $30 version, right? Which is also coming to retail. And, you know, $30 for what the game is does not seem wrong to me. You know, like, there's a lot of games like Defense Grid that launched at $30. Defense Grid 2, that is. And with Toy Soldiers, at least they have the excuse that they actually do have to pay for those licenses, you know? Like, they're not free. So...
I think Defense Grid was 20. 30 is kind of a lot. I don't think they charge that
sure?
much for it.
Somebody needs to check.
I'll see if I can find it.
Uh-oh, time's running out. I think I have to get the fuel back before it runs out. You can see it's getting pretty hectic already. A lot of stuff going on screen, but your guns can usually handle most of it. Yeah, you completed the level.
Even though you misspelled your entry, Brownmeister.
Come on, Brownmeister. That's not how to spell. Alright, this will be our last level, and then we'll go look at the retro mode if it is unlocked, which I think it will be, since it remembers my other levels. Actually, we might want to jump to, like, the highest level you can do, just to see what that's like. Yeah, if you like classic computer games and arcade games, then I think you will have a lot of fun with Jetpac. Even though it does get pretty tough, the core gameplay is really good. And there is some nice variety to the backgrounds. You can see they're changing every level. They might start repeating or something, but still, there's... A lot of games like this would just have, like, one background, or it would change every 10 levels or something.
You might want to look at your Skype settings, Paul, because when you stop talking, it starts increasing the volume of your mic.
Is that actually a Skype setting?
It is.
Yeah, if you have it set to auto... Adjust the volume.
Okay. Will you remind me about that later? Okay. I have no memory. Also, I didn't get a lot of sleep.
And just as a note, if you don't want your code, you can always just send it back to Paul.
Yeah, because tonight we're giving away 6 random Steam games that I had codes for. Because, remember, this particular stream came together really last minute. You know, like I said, I really needed to play this game more in order to review it by Monday, and I did not want to have to cancel the stream, so we threw this together last minute. If you don't want your Steam code that you win, please give it back, and we will use it for another stream someday in which things go crazy. So, I am gonna exit out of this. Having a real good time, like it a lot. Ultimate history. Learn about Ultimate, play the game, and the rich history of Jetpac. What's this? Oh, yeah, Rare used to be called Ultimate. So, nice little history thing there. And, of course, Rare Replay is going to have its own history section. But, gee, I actually... Oh, single player. Play Refueled or the classic original game. Here we go. Retro. So, here is the game that kept me from getting all 200 gamer score that I should have had. Back when I really cared about gamer score, too. Beautiful, isn't it? Actually, I do kind of miss this kind of look, you know? Like, I would play a modern game with a big scale that had this exact visual style, and I wouldn't mind at all. Would this be EGA or CGA? Brian, you still remember those, right? I think I'm seeing more than 4 colors on the screen. Blue, green, yellow, white, black. That's 5 in total. Oh, and purple. Yeah, so I guess that kind of qualifies as EGA, which was 16 colors on screen for DOS computers back in the day.
Man, that was before my time.
Really?
I'm only 30, man. Jeez.
Yeah, I never realized I was that much older than you. Yeah, so when you started using computers, probably VGA was already the standard, right? 256 colors or more.
Yeah, my first computer was a Pentium 1.
Nice. Yeah, I think Pentium 1 or Pentium 2 was my actual first computer that I owned, but I would go to friends' houses who could afford computers, you know, and play on their stuff.
Ah. Well, the first computer I ever used was an Apple, what was that? 2E, I think. Yeah, an Apple 2E.
And that was a game that would have had not a lot of... I mean, a computer that wouldn't have had a lot of colors on screen at once either, right?
I think it was at least 8-bit. But, you know, that was when I was in grade school.
Yep, back in the day. Commodore 64, Nin Zombie says he played. Yeah, Aru's Awakening. Thank you for remembering that, Bob. That is definitely what the game's art style reminds me of. So it doesn't seem unfairly hard yet, but I know that it gets that way. Like, you have to get decently far into this old game, and yeah, I just remember getting so frustrated over how hard it eventually got. But isn't it interesting to see a game, you know, evolve from these super basic visuals to a more modern style, and yet the actual gameplay is, you know, very practically the same. So that's how you do it. Is this how the original Prince of Persia looks? That game also got remade on a bunch of systems, like Super Nintendo, Turbo, Graphics, CD, you know.
Heck, they released a version for Xbox Live Arcade. They redid the graphics all nice and pretty, but...
So this is exactly the 360 version, like no changes?
Jetpac Refuelled? Yeah. Yeah, we're...
Yeah. But I know they mentioned how they're going to have like a rewind system for the games, but I guess the 360 versions
aren't. Right, none of those enhancements apply to the 360 versions. The only enhancements you could consider are that you can record video and do screenshots and snap things.
Okay. But yeah, because I thought if it would have got the rewind feature, that would have made it so much easier.
I know Swizz wanted to play Perfect Dark Zero. I haven't actually uploaded my save to the cloud, so I kind of don't want to waste any time on that. I still have a save. Traded that game in. You know, I bought it at launch. I was excited for it. Didn't like it very much. It's actually pretty crap, in my opinion. Although some people fell in love with it.
Well, the multiplayer is really good.
Yeah, it does have very robust multiplayer. And to get all the achievements, you would need to spend your entire life playing it.
Oh, yeah. I'm like halfway there to getting all the achievements.
Yeah, and some guy actually built a robot to do it for him. Back in the day, that was kind of newsworthy. And it's like, you're taking all the sport out of it, but on the other hand, they shouldn't design achievements that are that ridiculous like they were. Long box!
Yeah, you set up zombies mode with the bots in the lowest difficulty, and you can just kill them really fast until you get all your achievements.
Yeah, I kind of wish I had that level of ability. That would be a lot of fun, just to be able to make a robot do anything, heck. For Android Central, actually, I'm reviewing a learning robot system called Dash and Dot. It's these little toy robots, and you use your Android or iOS tablet to program them to do different things. And there's four different apps you can use to make them do things. So that's going to be interesting. What is the next game that we can do that is not Kameo yet and is not Viva Pinata?
Viva Pinata 2.
Or Viva Pinata 2, darn you. Aren't there a couple more?
Banjo-Kazooie, but that's kind of a...
Yeah, that's kind of a long, drawn-out game.
I wouldn't even be able to do, like, one level of Banjo-Kazooie in, like, 15 minutes.
Yeah, it's not really a quick game.
What about Banjo Nuts and Bolts?
That's not backwards compatible yet.
Crap, that's not fair.
But that probably would take longer than...
We'll just do Kameo. You know, Kameo is a really robust game, and it did not get a fair shake. So I think a lot of people who get Rare Replay are going to be pleasantly surprised by it.
For a launch game, it was fantastic.
Yeah, I remember my save data got corrupted, so I never finished it.
Oh, that's a shame.
Yeah.
Kameo it is.
We can do a straw poll if you want, and I'm pretty sure everyone would vote for Viva Pinata.
If I had more time, Bob, like, we just don't have a lot of time tonight.
Gotcha.
That's cool. Mongbox is familiar with Dash and Dot. Yeah. You know, she's a teacher, so she is into educational technology stuff. Looks like everything else is loaded up really fast after we got that initial 360 emulation going. So, Cald, you're right. Commodore 64 was fantastic. You know, it wasn't powerful enough to do, like, really faithful arcade game ports back in the day. Obviously, the Amiga, also by Commodore, was what did those. But, it had interesting versions of Bad Dudes, Double Dragon, many original games. Hello, Shoj Sauce. Here we are with Kameo Elements of Power. Her face is a little angular. One thing I never really liked about this game is that the creature designs are pretty fugly, in my opinion. Like, I think they got a lot better with Viva Pinata.
I done ban you. Don't listen to Bob.
I don't think I said hi to UCF. He's been here the whole time. Hello, UCF. UCF, to answer your question, even if you're not in the preview program, these games that come with Rare Replay, like Kameo here, they will appear in your library. Like, they will automatically install, and you'll be able to launch them like normal games.
The emulator specifics probably come with each download.
I imagine so.
Because each one's going to have its own little quirks that it has, which is what took forever to do Xbox backwards compat on the 360 originally.
Those have some big lips, dude. We're going to go ahead and launch Kameo. It does have an online multiplayer mode. Interestingly, that was not available when the game launched. They added it as a post-release feature, which was another nice show of support. Just for whatever reason, the mainstream gaming audience never embraced Kameo, but like I always thought it was, you know, like a top-tier launch title and definitely worthy of the rare name. New quest, start without saving. Why would I start without saving?
Wow, I didn't even know this had multiplayer.
Yeah, isn't that crazy? And I played the online multiplayer with a friend once, with a friend who I've invited to watch us stream on Twitch several times, and she just never will come. I don't know what's wrong with her. Let's see.
We scare her.
You know, some people have this weird mental block where they're unwilling to even try Twitch. I don't know what it is with people like that. Like, if I had a friend and they're like, hey, Paul, this is really cool, you got to try it, you know, I would, in fact, try it, unless it was drugs.
Come on. You know you want to try the snack. Yeah,
winners don't do drugs, ladies and gents. Let's see. Yep, you can invert your camera look, so this is perfectly Tyler friendly.
Well, except he, you know, got banned from Xbox Live.
Yeah, that part sucks. Shame he won't just get over it.
That's what happens when you invert your camera.
This started life, didn't it, as an N64 game, or was it an original Xbox game or GameCube? I forget. They just started developing it on an older system.
I think it was original Xbox. I think. A lot of the first games released on the 360 were originally started for Xbox.
It might have even been one where Nintendo would have published it on one of their platforms before Rare got bought up.
That's possible.
I like, you know, like naturally big lips, you know, and it's no secret that I like black girls, but yeah, I don't like collagen looking lips. No, thank you. And yet I am in favor of implants. So I'm just a man of contradictions.
Yeah, man. Come on now.
So I can leap and I can release. Let's just release. Got dudes in the background shooting at me. Running around. You do have full camera control with the right stick. I guess I was supposed to climb up there unless I can go in this door. What's this say? There's a piece of paper here, but I don't see what it does. You think it's a respawn point? I can do a flip kick.
I say it could be. It's been, you know, almost a decade since I played this.
You need to catch up on your retro gaming, man. This is why you need Rare Replay Collection.
Well, I own this game, nice. So. But I will still probably buy the collection, simply because it's got a lot of games that I
Heck
don't
yeah.
own.
Yeah. The most special thing about the collection to me is that it comes with Battletoads Arcade, which was never released on any home platform before.
So wow. It comes with Battletoads and Battletoads Arcade.
Yes, well, the original Battletoads is awful, so...
Yeah, that's just a punishing game. I watch people stream that just as a torture session.
It's so weird. Because they had every element that could have made a good, memorable game that would have been a hit. You know, like, they had a good engine, nice art style, characters that were, you know, good for the time. You know, because Ninja Turtles was so popular when Battletoads came out, right? And then... Just their level designer, you know, he had too much crack or whatever and decided that the game should be impossibly hard. And so, you know, you would rent the game or buy it, you'd get to the third level, and you could never get any farther. And this is a game with, like, 11 or more levels. So, you know, it's like, why did they even bother designing any levels after that? Because maybe 1% of players who played the game actually got to see the rest of it.
They do have, like, secret shortcuts you can take, though, that make the level a lot easier.
I'm talking about the racing levels. I don't think there's anything you can do to get around them.
There's some secret parts, like, you'll advance you further in the game.
Like a warp thing? Oh.
Yeah.
In the form of Chilla, you should be able to climb this ice. Use left stick and pull the right trigger to leap across the ice. Okay, but how do I change back into Chilla? Oh, that's
right. Press X.
My bad. Yeah, no, I mean, the first few levels of Battletoads were fun, but so-called, you can't tell me you beat level 3 of Battletoads. I wouldn't believe you. So.
I've seen someone beat it before.
Yeah, no, not that no one ever has in the history of time, but I don't think back then, you know, it's just very unlikely that people were willing to put in that time, in my opinion. Ow, just got shot.
I've seen streamers do it before on Twitch.
Yeah.
But, yeah, you know, these are people.
But if you get in the co-op, that's real fun.
Oh, man.
That was another thing it had going for it, co-op. But then, you know, Battletoads, that wasn't the only Battletoads game. Thankfully, it was enough of a hit that it got some sequels. There's Super Battletoads, which graphically definitely was really cool. I cannot remember what it was like difficulty-wise. Unfortunately, Super Battletoads is not included in Rare Replay Collection. Then there was Battletoads Double Dragon, the weird, weird crossover game that came out on Super Nintendo, Genesis, and I think it even came out on NES and Game Boy and Game Gear.
They were streaming that particular Battletoads game on SGDQ earlier today.
Oh, Battletoads Double Dragon? Nice.
Yeah.
You know, it was... The Double Dragon stuff was pretty well implemented. So, you know, as a huge, lifelong Double Dragon fan, I really liked that one. Push and hold right trigger to push up ramps. Okay, how do I walk around?
This already looks like Plants vs. Zombies. Yeah, and Shovel Knight has a really good Battletoads reference.
Oh yeah, that is true.
There are so many references in that game.
Yeah, the Battletoads one is done really well.
I'm glad you think so, Ninzombie. I'm not playing it very well. Like I mentioned, I'm really sleepy today, unfortunately. But I'm doing my best. Ooh, burst through that. Yeah, at any time you can have three transformations equipped, and so that's what I've got. They are mapped to the face buttons, and A changes you back to Kameo, which I was not realizing. Huh, which way do I actually go? That one has blue lights. I'll go the way that doesn't have any lights. One thing I don't have today is a sense of direction. Icky, I think it always looked like this. I think it always looked really good. Although it's possible the frame rate is better. What does that say? A charge spin. Oh, no, that is the way I came. Major ruin. Font looks a little squishy to me. Thank you for running the contest, Brian.
No problem. That's why I get quiet occasionally. It requires me to concentrate. Which is not saying much.
This actual level, the way it's panning around like this, kind of reminds me of Skylanders. Skylanders has some similar junk, although the perspective is a little bit different visually. There's stuff I can knock around in ball form. I don't know if there's any purpose to that. Woo! Way to go. And by the way, hello, Dinev. Dinev, you need to stay in touch on Skype better, man. I send you messages sometimes, but I so rarely hear back from you. Ah. Dinev participated in our farming simulator stream, and he was a big help that night. I still hope that we can do some other kind of multiplayer stream sometime. The blue spirit bar drains when you use your strong abilities. It will refill after a few seconds. Okay, so there's the blue spirit bar. Yeah, I never quite beat this game. I really want to go back and finish it someday. I don't know if that's ever going to happen. Uh-oh, here come the bad guys. So I think we should talk some about QuakeCon. I know at least a few of our viewers were looking forward to hearing about the trip to QuakeCon. The bad news about QuakeCon is that Tyler got dysentery like right before QuakeCon, so he wasn't able to come.
Jeez,
yeah,
man.
That's a shame.
Poor guy.
Yeah, so even, I mean, Tyler did not come to QuakeCon like we promised you guys, and that was just out of my hands. And, you know, I'm so sorry, because I wanted to do some special stuff with him. And, I mean, you know, I took my family along. My whole family was looking forward to meeting him. It did not work out. But in his place, we had another friend of the stream, so-called gamer, came. And so I got to meet him. And, you know, I hadn't talked to so-called gamer in a long time, but he was cool enough to agree to come along, and we had a lot of fun. He actually appears in a video that we published at Windows Central today. And that would be in our article about the game Bombshell. Bombshell is an upcoming twin-stick shooter action RPG from 3D Realms, the original creators of Duke Nukem. They're sort of making a comeback. They were bought by a company called Interceptor in Denmark, and so now their work, Bombshell, is going to be like basically their return to form, and then hopefully they'll make lots more games in the future. So we got to play Bombshell, and we did a little interview with the game developer. And if you watch the interview video, I hope you guys will all watch this video, because I'm pretty proud of it. But we started out with a little sketch with me and so-called in it. And then it becomes a regular interview after that. But, like, if you've watched the stream much and you've heard me talk about, you know, we kind of parody something that actually happened in the gaming world at the beginning of the sketch. And still, I'm just really happy with how it turned out. So please, please watch that video. Watch it twice. Tell your friends. And be sure to leave a comment on the article, as always, because, you know, guys, that is a big help to us. It's very important. You know, like, we can tell who supports the stream and who doesn't by who leaves comments on the articles, because, like, it's not a lot of trouble to leave those comments. So what am I supposed to do to get this guy to come out of the... Oh, boy, I respawned way far back. That's great. Yeah. All right, we'll go back, and hopefully somebody will be able to give me advice.
Yeah, don't look at me. It's been, you know, years.
That would be fun. If I could get prizes for World of Tanks, I definitely would love to do a weekend World of Tanks stream. And I bet, I mean, in the past I tried to get in touch with the developer, the publisher, and they were not very receptive. You know, they never answered my emails, but I'll try again. I'm better at that stuff. It's been a few years. So maybe I need to be the gorilla guy.
Maybe. Punch. Yeah, it does give you all three of your transformations here, so it might just want you to switch.
Oh, and in fact, I'll read the little hint things.
Oh, yeah, the hint things will probably help.
Pummelweed's creeper technique, that's it. All right. Pummel.
And I also forgot to ask, what is that thing you're holding in the video?
That is my new digital audio recorder, which Brian actually helped me pick out.
I thought you were going to shoot him.
Yeah, it does have a pistol grip on it. That
It looked like you're like, all right, I need my interview. Or
here's the thing.
Holding him hostage.
You can use it without the grip. Like, however, some people say that it picks up too much noise from your hands shaking. Like, the grip apparently reduces that, you know, prevents that from happening for the most part. So that's why I'm using the grip.
Gotcha. Yeah, I could see that.
Yeah, and actually, we even have a comparison video that compares the audio with and without, you know, like the camera's natural audio, which is how I've done my, you know, my convention videos previously, like at E3, and then the new...
Do you want me to share that one?
If you still have the link. Yeah.
Yeah, well,
if you guys want to open this up in another tab and just check it out, like, to see the difference, what a difference this recorder makes. The recorder, it was like $140. But it makes such a significant difference in sound quality.
Let me look, make sure. Yep, that's the right one. Okay, good.
This guy. There we go. Okay, knocked his shell off, finally.
Hunkies. Oh boy, where'd you guys go?
Yeah, we went to a restaurant called Hunkies in the gay district of Dallas, which we didn't realize when we were picking it.
Hey man, sometimes those places are a lot of fun.
Yeah, it was a cool place. So now I can progress. There's more enemies to fight. I guess I'll be the gorilla dude. Do I need to kill these enemies? I don't actually know. All right, let's shoot our ice powers. Ah! I got trolls stuck on my back. Now I can hurl them away using left trigger or club. That's interesting. Let's throw one.
Oh yeah, if I remember right, you can slam them on the spikes on your back.
Yeah, that's what I just did. That is a very unique power. Like, they were pretty creative. And I just threw the enemies off of me. Oh, and I'm in the... down. Yeah, I'm in this first-person view, and I can still just throw ice spikes. Exit, left trigger.
I like how it gives you the really close over-the-shoulder third person when you're throwing.
Yeah, throwing yeah. So, something. Cole, I'll definitely share those pictures with you soon. I'm still catching up. You know, like, I haven't even finished writing all my QuakeCon articles. Like, there's at least two more articles I need to write. And, you know, when we got back from the trip, I was really tired. And this is a problem with me, is that, like, yeah, those things take a lot out of me, and I come back beat. But we'll get one of those articles up tomorrow. God, this guy will not stop hitting me.
Was it a long
drive?
Yeah,
5-hour drive.
From where you live to Dallas? Wow, that's pretty long. I forget, Texas is pretty big.
Biggest state in the country that's a real state.
Oh, that's cold. Hopefully we don't have any Alaskans in here.
Well. It's funny, I want to have, like, some kind of irrational prejudice about Alaskans because of, you know, that lady, the political lady who came from there and her...
Oh, yeah,
yeah,
crazy
and her
pants.
Awful daughter. You know, the one who preaches... Oh, man, we're not going to talk about it. So-called will get mad. Yeah.
How about we just leave that crazy lady out of this
yeah.
conversation?
Point She's is, if that's all you know about Alaska, you would probably think that Alaska is like a backwater place. But it's probably like Texas in that, you know, you have your backwater people or areas, and then you have your, you know, educated areas. I'm sure it's the same deal. So, I don't like how Kameo doesn't have a default attack. Like, you have to hold left trigger and right trigger to actually do an attack when you're her. I would rather she had just map that to just a single button.
Well, the problem with mapping that to a button is your face buttons are mapped to your powers. They could have mapped that to the D-stick or something.
Yes, yeah, something.
Or the crosshairs.
I don't think the game uses the bumpers, so that's what I would have assigned it.
Yeah. Really? I didn't know Rowdy Rowdy.
Oh,
Bucket
yeah,
had.
Which is really sad. I made a tweet about that.
Man.
So,
not into wrestling myself, but
there's
your name.
A thank you, Ninzombie. Yeah, like I said,
I just didn't want to say her name. I knew
I don't have a lot of memory recall tonight due to the lack of sleep. Oh, that guy burned me to death when I knocked him on my back. Please don't send me too far back. Got a death animation.
It's gonna send you back a million years.
Continue. Yes. Okay. Well, good. At least you remembered that I killed those enemies.
Wow, what a dramatic death animation with purple fire.
Yeah, really.
All kinds
Why don't
of
more games
stuff.
Have FMV play when you die? So I gotta figure out how to kill that fire guy. I'm thinking maybe just throw bodies at him.
Texas is only the biggest if you actually use facts. Alaska's only the biggest. Never mind. I can't think tonight.
Well, oh, yeah. Is Alaska like Hawaii in that they kind of took it by force?
No, we bought it from
okay,
Russia.
Well, that is more legitimate.
Wow, using that guy as a club. That's pretty
yeah,
awesome.
This fire dude is tripping me up.
I would switch to the what is that, armadillo type character with the spikes?
Yeah, definitely that guy.
Because the big furry guy is probably not going to do so well with fire.
Yeah, he killed me before. So I don't think I'm supposed to roll into him. Maybe if I do the cyclone, how about that? Does that do anything? You just kind of roll around like crazy. It doesn't look like it did anything. I need it. Oh! I bumped him. I don't know if I took any damage or not. Your axe is unguarded, but getting up to it may be tricky. Don't be afraid to experiment with your abilities. Don't fall, for goodness sake. Isn't there one that tells me how to fight the guy? Because I'm sure later in the game I'm going to have to fight more fire dudes. And what is this exit they're talking about? You know he's going to kill the crap out of me. Yeah, so-called, maybe we do need that. It wouldn't be really good to have something owned by Russia right up there so close to America, would it? It'd be a bunch of missile silos pointed at us.
So you can't push one of the other balls into them?
Maybe. Let's try that.
Sorry, I'm running the contest a little fast tonight because I don't know exactly how long Paul wants to stream.
Yeah, guys, I've probably got about 10 or 15 more minutes in me. So about QuakeCon, we do have some good articles already up on the site. I would love for you guys to read them. The cream of the crop is my Doom multiplayer impressions, which I've already shared with several of you. But yeah, I got to play Doom multiplayer at the convention, and you know, nobody else who, you know, only people who attended the convention got to do that, and not everybody even then, because it was very popular. But you know, as the press, they let me in so-called play, and it was really good fun. So if you were not excited about Doom before, I think you should be if you like first-person shooters, because it was great. It's traditional, you know, like some people would like to see more, like, you know, unique new mechanics and stuff, but I mean, like, there's nothing wrong with traditional when traditional is really polished, and that is what it is like.
Cool.
Isn't that... Haven't I already been here? Yeah, I...
Do you even have to kill the fire guy?
No, I did not have to, so I got out of there. Oh, this is neat. Even the rolling ball dude can get the orcs stuck on his back. Or he can get at least one stuck on him. But I don't know where to go from here. Saving content. Oh. And now I've just gone into some kind of slow-mo death fury mode. I don't know. Is it from getting a combo going? Yeah, see? So-called liked it too. And like me, So-called is not a big first-person shooter gamer. So that's how you know that they've got something special there, is that even though it's not our genre of choice, we came away highly impressed. I think I'm supposed to go up there.
Hey, light cycle.
Can I just... Alright, let's throw these guys off. Get off me. I'm holding L to aim. You have to wait till it goes into throw mode. I'm pushing R to hurl, and it's not doing it.
Can't blame you on a free dinner there, Light Cycle.
Oh, yeah. By the way, good seeing you, Light Cycle. So, QuakeCon, that was a great experience. Like I said, at least one or two more stories coming up. I shot an interview with somebody else. A guy. Actually, an education-related interview, because it's from school with a gaming program, you know, a gaming degree or something. Yeah, and cool. I need to edit that video and finish that story up, but I'm sure Mongbox will enjoy that, and hopefully everybody will give it a look. Please do leave a comment on the Bombshell article. Like I said, make sure you watch the video. Please leave a comment on the Doom multiplayer article if you haven't seen it yet. A little more to come from that. I hope that more of you guys will come next year. You know, like, I would like for... Because QuakeCon is a free convention, it takes out the cost of going to the convention that we might have if we tried to do a meetup at, like, Penny Arcade Expo, which does cost money. You know, like...
Well, Penny Arcade's also really difficult to get into, because don't they do the tickets on a lottery? Unless you're pressed.
Early on, you might just be able to buy them, but... At PAX South, there was no problem getting tickets for regular people, but they do sell out. Like, that's the thing, is the tickets are limited. QuakeCon, the tickets are unlimited. Everybody can get some. Everybody can get in. Yeah,
nice.
And it is, like I said, it's a slower paced convention. There's not as much in the way of panels and stuff, but it still is perfect for a meetup. Like, there's enough stuff going on that you can go there and have a good time. And then also, oh, there's a tunnel to go into. I bet that's where I want to go. Let's try that. Oh, I wasn't going fast enough. That's lame. But yeah, please consider coming along next year, you guys. If you remain a part of our community and you would like to meet other members of our Twitch streaming community, then let's make that happen next year. That goes for you too as well. All right. Here we go.
Hopefully I will have recovered by then, because I think I'm going to end up at Ignite again next year.
The Texas isn't as hot.
Yeah, the temperature the outside temperature was absolutely awful, so I can't lie about that. But, you know, like, you get there, you drive to the convention, you go in, and you don't come outside until it's time to go back to your hotel or wherever you're going, you know? Come on.
That's the best way to do
it. Like, you know, I am very sensitive to hot temperatures. I hate being hot. I hate sweating. But, you know, I still obviously am able to be a productive citizen of Texas, you know.
Don't move to Florida.
Pretty hot there, too.
We just go from one air-conditioned space to another. Pretty much all year round. It never really gets cold.
Yeah, at least we do have some cold times here, or times that we consider cold, and then northerners are like, that's not cold, I go outside that way naked, and I'm like,
No, probably, it's 80 degrees, it's so cold.
No, I mean, like, in the winter, it may get down to the 30s or 40s sometimes here, which obviously is not as cold as if you live in a snowy area, but it's still uncomfortably cold right now.
I don't know, maybe if you're from the south.
Goofballs. See, Bob goes out naked that way too. So what I need to do is get into that hole, but the thing is, I don't really know how to build up momentum that well. Maybe if I'm going to try starting from farther back and seeing if it helps.
You might want to start from closer up, crap. Actually.
Oh, you know what? I just got in. It all worked out. Going through a tunnel, kind of Metroid-like, if you think about it, rolling around through tunnels. And am I in a new area? I hope so. There is a box here, and a fire guy. Oh, I just love those fire guys. Major ruin. Push R will allow you to hover. Oh, so he can hover, and then you can extend your jump. Aim left and right. Okay, let's try this. This is too much. Yep, that's it. You just freeze in the air. You push R a second time. That's not bad.
Oh, cool.
So, Oswego, what is that, Ninzombie? Is that like an Indian burial ground? What are we talking about here? Are you in Canada or are you in North America? Tell us where you are, more specifically. Can't directly defeat roll trolls, so you have to find another way to put them down and out. Use your head. I'm not in a puzzle solving mood. But one thing that was impressive about this game back when it came out is it's one of those games that has a lot of little ambient enemies in the background, kind of like Gears of War did. You know, like, you can see there's a bunch of flying enemies way back there, and that was something you wouldn't have seen on the previous generation.
Yeah, they just didn't have the horsepower to put non-interactive characters in the background.
Defeat all the roll trolls to unlock the gate. Once they're down, use Shola's ice spike to strike the crystal. Oh god, they want me to use like multiple techniques in a row and everything. So I guess I would like to share with everybody the good news about next week. Next week we are still going to have a stream, you guys. In 2 weeks, I am likely to be out of town again. You know, I just got back from QuakeCon, right? But now it turns out that I have another trip ahead of me to the continent of Europe.
That's pretty awesome.
Yeah.
I'm very jealous.
It's crazy. I'll be visiting a country in Europe that is not one that I think is on everybody's must-visit list. But it is still pretty cool to be able to leave the country at all.
You going to Liechtenstein?
To Latvia.
Ah.
I believe it's capital city, Kriga. I hope that's the capital and not just a regular city. Definitely a big city in Latvia. And hopefully, I understand the country is ruled by Dr. Doom, so that's going to be... Hopefully don't run afoul of him.
Hmm.
It's probably masking off right now.
Yeah, well, I mean, anybody who reads Marvel Comics knows that Dr. Doom rules Latvia, so...
Oh, I don't read comic
it's
books.
Actually, it's an in-joke. He rules a country called Latveria.
That
sounds a
I
lot
see.
Like Latvia, if you ask me. So that's how I had to kill that roll troll. I had to knock him into the fire. Yeah, what's in there is the Game Insight's headquarters is located there. Game Insight is a mobile publisher. They're a big supporter of Windows Phone and Windows 8. They're not as well known as Gameloft. Yeah, but they do make a lot of money. They make a lot of city-building games. They also have some other games. Like, they have one called Running Shadow that's going to come to Windows 10. That's a 3D endless running game with an actual, like, you know, story mode and stuff. And they've been really cool to me over the years. I first met them at Casual Connect a few years back. And, you know, ever since then, like, they have had me on their swag list, and they've, you know, worked with me to make sure that we cover some of their games and stuff. And so now they have a thing where they are bringing some journalists over there to do some interviews and see some games and stuff. And, you know, how could you say no to that? How could you say no? I could not say no. But I'm supposed to leave on the 14th if everything works out. However, the bad thing is they didn't give me very much notice, and I don't have a passport yet. So I am scrambling to get a passport. I have an appointment on the 7th, on Friday. So as long as my passport meeting goes well, then I will get to go, and it'll be great.
You are cutting it close on that one, man.
Yeah, and that is completely not my fault. I think they, you know, like the people who run this company, they travel back and forth all the time. They probably didn't realize that, by the way, not everyone has a passport.
Well, most Americans never leave the country. I mean, I just applied for a passport, you know, 2 weeks ago.
What for?
Possibly a trip to Europe.
That sounds great.
Maybe. I don't know.
England or a different country?
France and England, if we're going. So, could be fun.
Depend on finances, or what's the deciding factor of whether you go or not?
Yeah, probably.
Well, I hope you're able to, man.
Hopefully. Well, yeah, aren't passports good for, like, 7 or 10 years
yes,
or something like that?
Yes, 10 years. They're expensive.
Yeah, tell me about
it. It sucks for me because I'm kind of broke from QuakeCon, actually, so, like, I wish this was spaced out differently. But still, I'm going to have to try to go. And just hopefully there won't be many things that require me to have money when I get there. And the euro is strong against the dollar, so that means that things are going to be more expensive, right?
No, they're actually about even right now.
Well, that's better. I can live with that. All right, now where am I supposed to go? I think I'm supposed to shoot some kind of crystal with the ice dude. That's an interesting thread, NinZombie. You should email or private message it to me, and I will be sure to give it a look. Like, I'm super busy, so there's a lot of things I would like to do that I never get around to doing, but still, I would like to give it a look. Maybe by crystal they mean this red crystal right here. Let's find out. Aim. And shoot. Let's see if it does anything. Spike! I'm pushing it. It's not throwing. This is weird. It actually will not let me throw it at this Nope, there it goes. I hope my right trigger's not going out. Alright. Now I gotta be Pummelweed.
Yeah, I would say the Xbox One controller is quite a bit more fragile than the 360 one.
That's...
Because I haven't had mine for that long, and it's already starting to... one of the triggers is starting to act a little funny.
Shame. Now, who am I supposed to...
Yeah, I want my third controller.
I think I'll be Kameo at this part. Running across, nice camera effects. Yeah, the passport itself, if I didn't have to pay the expedited fee, would be $135. However, I am going to have to pay an expedited fee, makes it $195 in total. And, yeah.
Yeah, that sounds about right. I think mine was $168 because I also got the little card that lets you go to the Bahamas. Kind of looks like a driver's license, but it's, you know, wider.
Gotcha. Yeah, I had the option of getting that, but I don't need it right now. I can go back and get it later if I would use it. You can use it for Canada and Mexico also.
Yeah, but if you have a regular passport. Oh, you know, there's not really a reason.
Creeper can punch enemies. That's good. Yeah, so anyway, wish me luck on getting my passport and being able to go to that. You guys, it's not something that will affect the stream very much, except that I will be out of town. Ah! So, you know, we'll have to get Tyler or Brian to sub.
I'm sure somebody will fill in.
Exactly. And I hate having to be away on a lot of Saturdays, you know, in a short period of time, but those are just the breaks.
Well, that's how it goes. Yeah, passport, yeah, that's actually quite a bit cheaper there, Icky. You know, $75, but it's actually about the same amount if you take into the fact that U.S. passports are 10 years. So you're coming up to about the same dollar figure there.
You have to have it just to fish on Lake Erie? Wow, because I guess it crosses borders.
Yeah, it could, depending on how far you go, okay. I suppose.
Well, at least I got my life refilled. You know, the checkpoints can be a little far apart for my taste, but, you know, modern games usually put them pretty close.
Oh, okay, I know why. Because if you go to the other side of the lake and just hop off, you know, anywhere, they're not going to know.
Yep.
So they have to treat it like you're going into Canada.
It's a reasonable restriction.
Yeah. Yeah,
we talked about
that.
This when Alejandro was on the stream during an informal stream one time, but like a country securing its borders and controlling immigration is actually pretty important, and it's a really weird thing that in America there's a lot of people who don't believe in this very basic concept of sovereignty, you know, like, but that's just the weird world we live in.
Well, the one thing I don't understand, and I'm probably going to get a lot of hate for this, is... Whoa. The whole idea of each individual state controlling things like driver's licenses. Why doesn't the entire U.S. have one set of driving standards that everyone abides by?
I don't
get it.
I guess it's just one of those things where they want the state to still have some control. But yeah, it is a weird thing.
I think it's a holdout of, you know, being a 200-year-old... republic that, you know, people just don't want to give that up.
You are probably right. Oh, Icky can't go to Israel. That's too bad, Icky. It sounds like such a nice place. People...
Yes, the desert.
Yep, people fighting all the time. Rockets overhead.
Mm-hmm.
Just lovely. But...
I wonder why they don't let you go to Israel. It's kind of weird.
Is it a political thing? Like...
It's probably... religious thing.
Oh,
he's from
right.
An Islamic country. That's just crazy.
So do you get more powers later?
Yeah, because there's a total of 12 different creatures. Like, I don't know if this is considered a level. I think it's a level. You know, like, there's a hub world for sure, but there may be individual distinct levels, as I recall. So I'm probably getting pretty close to the end. I mean, I might as well try to finish it, because it can't be that much longer, I would think. But... Also, I really need to be getting ready for work, so we'll see how it goes. Hey, Sergeant Torrente! No, I have not heard anything about UNO, unfortunately, becoming backwards compatible, but I mean, you know, there will be more backwards compatible games announced in the months to come, so...
But you won't be able to use the camera for it, so I don't know if it's worth playing
anyways.
Yeah,
like, if I can't play UNO naked and have people see me naked, then I'm not sure I want to play it.
Yeah, same here.
Oh, boy.
Icky agrees the reason he can't go to Israel is because of the religious factor.
Yeah, that it makes sense given Israel's particular leanings, but it's still silly.
Yep.
Wow, your microphone's going crazy there.
Come on, Bob, talk to us.
Yeah, man, come on. You've been MIA this whole stream.
This is pretty fun. It looks like it's a fun game.
Yeah, if you guys in the audience, let us know what you think of Kameo specifically. Because like I said, it's a game that I like pretty well. And I know a lot of people missed it because it just didn't, for some reason, catch on with the public consciousness.
And deletes your saves randomly.
Hopefully that won't be an issue on the bone. We'll see. Because it'll have the cloud save backup, so maybe. I hope I don't have to defeat the fire guy, because I still don't know how to defeat him.
You might try throwing an ice, like an ice pick at him, or whatever that...
Yeah, but you pick up another enemy and then throw them at him.
Well, that's true.
Okay,
you
fine, we'll
too.
Try that. Come here, dude.
Unless you killed everybody
else. No, I got one right here. Yeah, no, actually my computer is pretty loud. It might be picking up sound from the computer, too, because the fan I turned off. Well, I threw it at the enemy and nothing happened, but let's try an ice spike now. Hey, that worked. I knocked him off the edge. Woo! I've always really liked throwing enemies off of edges in games, because like in the original Double Dragon, if you were, you know... Like, Double Dragon didn't have very complex fighting mechanics, but you could style it up by, you know, like, grabbing enemies and throwing them off of ledges. So that was always my favorite thing to try to do. And yes, in this, you can toss enemies off of ledges as well. So how many more enemies do I have to fight? Like, what else is going on over here? I don't see anyone else.
Yeah, I don't know where you're supposed to go.
Hello, Pro 969. Good to see you. Has Pro 969 been to the stream before? Ah.
I believe the name looks familiar.
Ow. Yeah, now I've got an enemy that only Tumbleweed or whatever can fight. Come on.
Yeah, Edge has a lot of issues. You might want to try something else. Internet Explorer 11 is in there still. So.
Yeah, I'm being required to switch to Windows 10 so I can write some articles about it this week. That's going to be interesting. Like, I really wanted to wait like a month to switch to it. But if they need me to, then so I will.
I got your whole article here.
I do, but
it still needs work. It's broken.
Yeah.
There you go. I just wrote it for
well,
you.
Well, it's not a review. Like, they want us to write, like, how to do this, how to do that. And, like, one of it is best, like, they want me to write about the best first-person shooter games for Windows 10. And aren't the games on the Windows 10 store just Windows 8 games?
No.
Some of them are, yeah. But they're starting to release universal games.
Yeah, because I know, like, Solitaire, I think that's separate from Windows 8 Solitaire.
Yeah, it's a new one. They rewrote it.
Yes, has a 1,000 gamer score.
1,000, that's pretty cool. Except, you know, for the way the game is set up like a free to play game.
Eh, yeah. You can still play it. Sure, you just have to look at the ads. Major...
Yeah, I think you can get rid of the ads if you pay for it.
Oh.
Well, it's $10 a year.
Yeah, that's not bad. It's all there.
Ah, crap. Man, where'd these stupid enemies come from? So it's bad enough I have to do this challenging platforming bit, and now they have what looks like an endless stream of enemies coming at me. So I gotta go across here, now switch to him, and climb. Ooh, I did it! So yeah, you're gonna have to switch back and forth between abilities. Ah. Killed you. Oh, he killed me too. Wonderful. And Zombie is saying something about having a stroke. We won't talk about streaming naked and having strokes, will we?
Yeah, that's a heck of a way for the EMTs to show up.
Does not make lewd joke, except I kind of made the joke anyway. Yeah, man. And Mongbox the other day, I forget whose stream it was, but she set everybody up for a really good naughty joke, too. I was just like, man, I wish I could say that naughty joke. All right. Boy, this level is just going on and on, isn't it?
Yes, it is. Hey, for $30, you're going to get, you know, some serious game time.
Yeah, I mean, Kameo is a huge full game, complete with separate online multiplayer levels and stuff. And I think the multiplayer levels have achievements or not, but... And this is just one game. Rare Replay has so many classic, interesting games. And you got the Viva Pinata games, which Bob loves, and those are also massive. Although, like, isn't it a case, Bob, where if you have Viva Pinata 2, you don't need Part 1?
Yeah, that's what pretty I thought. Much.
But still, yeah, Viva Pinata Trouble in Paradise, which I bought for $5 when it was on sale one time on Games On Demand.
Nice.
I tried to go to midnight release, and GameStop was not open.
Oh. Wow, that's a little telling.
Yeah, it was bad. I never went to GameStop again.
I just don't go to GameStop anymore.
I don't unless I have to, which is very infrequently. You know, like, I hardly ever sell games, and especially now that Xbox One and Vita, you know, have full digital support, I hardly ever even get retail games. But I probably do need to thin my 360 collection out some. It's just, like, if we knew what was going to end up being backwards compatible and what wasn't, then that would make that an easier thing to do.
I think they've said that everything, they're aiming for every single Xbox 360 game to be backwards compatible. Whether they reach that goal or not, who knows, but they have stated that that's what they want to do.
Yeah, I just, you know, it's an I'll believe it when I see it thing, because, you know, what happened with 360? How many original Xbox games were playable? Maybe like one out of four games.
Maybe 100 total?
Yeah, not enough.
Yeah. They said their goal, barring any licensing issues and publishers just telling them no, that that's what they want to do. Hey, it looks like you're the boss.
Yeah, so I am actually at the end of the level. Bad thing is, the level is probably going to be hard. I mean, the boss, it looks like it's going to be a hard thing.
Well, you try throwing ice spikes.
It said I needed to get a good punch in on him first.
Oh, that means you need to do an uppercut.
Yeah, so that's what I'm...
Yeah.
There we go. Got him. Now what? Ah! Now all the rest of the enemies just wail on me, because that's what they do in this game. They gang up on you.
Viva Pinata 2, you cannot access everything because it used the vision camera for some of the achievements.
Yeah, the Kinect camera games won't work.
So the best thing to do would be to get those achievements on the 360, upload your save to the cloud, and then continue playing after that, I guess would be it.
Yeah, you'd have to have a vision camera, though, not a Kinect.
Oh, dang.
A vision camera? What's
that? I actually sold mine. It was the webcam for the 360.
Yeah, it came with Uno.
Wow, I didn't even know it had one.
Yeah, and Bomberman Live used to support the camera, but then they killed the support and never really told anybody, which was dumb. All right.
In Burnout Paradise, you used it too. When if you took somebody out, they would see a picture of you.
This fight is BS. Yeah, that's a cool implementation. There's a lot of things. Like, I wish Xbox One games would do that. The Kinect has camera support. It wouldn't be hard to just pull a picture. Like, very minimal developer work, but still, they just...
Some do. I know iDarb has some fun camera stuff.
Yeah, at least. Too bad iDarb doesn't have a fun game to go along with it.
Yeah, it really needs online multiplayer.
It's fun, but you need to have, you know, eight friends
to play
with.
Yeah, it needs real full online multiplayer, and it doesn't have anything like that, so... So now, how do I... The guy unstuns too quickly, and the ice throw thing is terrible. So, you know, like, I don't know if it's my controller or just the game. But that's what I gotta do.
Well, I think you're supposed to stun him with the uppercut and then switch to something else.
Right, so I'm switching to the ice guy, and then I try to throw. Woo! That hit him. Did it take life away? I don't know if it took life away or not. It doesn't show the guy's life.
It does. It's there on the left.
Oh, you're right. Okay, so it is hell. Woo, that time it let me throw two crystals. All right, I think I'm going to be able to do this, guys. This will be a great cutting off point. So you guys in the audience, I know that Brian plans to get Rare Replay, but do any of you other guys plan to get it? Like, I'm a big fan of classic collections, and it's really neat that this collection is so diverse, because it's, you know, it covers a lot of different eras and platforms. And
well, heck, it spans, what, 30 years?
Insane. And it's console exclusive, so, like, it's nice to see an exclusive collection like this come to Xbox One for once, because I don't think we had much like that on 360 or Xbox One. I mean, I'm sorry, original Xbox. Throw it! Ha! Got him! Like, there are collections that would come out on PlayStation systems only. That happened often enough, like some great Taito collections. We got one on the original Xbox, but the PlayStation 2 got some way better ones.
Yeah, I use my PS3 mostly as a, you know, old remastered PS2 collection box.
Yeah, that's why I would have a hard time selling my PS3 as well. I have a Japanese PS3 that can play Japanese PS2 and 1 games, so
nice.
It is pretty cool, but you know, how often do I actually play those games? Very, very infrequently. But it's hard to give up on your past like that. You know, like, I sold off my original 3DO, and I had a great collection of games for that, and I always regret it, because there were a few games on it that never came out on anything else, and I just wish, you know, if I had the craving for it, that I could play those games. Like, there was a Sailor Moon fighting game that, like, the actual gameplay wasn't very good, but as a Sailor Moon collectible, it was really cool. And there was a first-person shooter from Japan called Iron Angel of the Apocalypse. In Japan, it was just called Tatsujin. And it, like, the story, it had these full-motion video cinemas, and they really stuck with me. Like, they were really unique, and that was a very atmospheric game. I wish somebody would re-release it on computer, because I would totally buy it in an instant. And also, it would run a million times better, because it did not run very well. Scary lizard lady with only one eye.
Nice.
I'm not a child, and yes, I know who. Very
good. Now, Light Cycle. Would you like to
explain why you stole? What's Light Cycle saying?
He asked if your Japanese PS3 supports Japanese Blu-ray porn.
But of course. No, Blu-rays. Oh, yeah. Well, I mean, usually those would not be region-locked to begin with, but yeah, American and Japanese Blu-ray players play the same discs. They're part of the same Blu-ray region.
Yeah, they're both part of A. I think Europe is B and China is C.
And that sounds like a good thing, that we can play Japanese discs natively, but actually, like, for anime fans, it ends up being really bad, because Blu-rays cost like 2 or 3 times more over there than they do here, because Japan has a really corrupt movie industry, or home video industry, and music, same way. Like, their stuff, crazy expensive, and so everybody pirates over there because the prices are so high. But here's the thing, people would reverse import. Like, they have this fear of Japanese people buying the American versions of Blu-rays, like Dragon Ball or whatever. So, like, they either will not. So in general, we, like, a licensor will not let them release a Japanese anime over here if it has not already been out in Japan for like a year, because they want to get their sales of their expensive overpriced version before they let the possibility of people importing the American version become a thing. I hope I said that right. I know I'm not very well spoken.
Yeah, it's, well, imagine paying like $30 or $40 for a CD. And you have the idea of what it costs in Japan. Just for, you know, a standard Taylor Swift CD, for example, it's like $40. A DVD is like $50 or $60. A game is, you know, ridiculous. It's just crazy.
Well, their games actually are not usually that much more expensive nowadays. Yeah, like a typical game, maybe $70 or $80, which is more than what we pay, but not horrendously more, you know what I'm saying? And some of them are less. Like, they do have lower price point games. But movies and music, you know, forget about it. Like, one volume of an anime, like 4 episodes of a show, they'll release it as it comes out, right? That one volume may cost like $50 to $70 over there. Yeah.
Jeez, I thought it was bad when anime first started over here.
Yeah, even our, but I mean, compared to VHS, because VHS tapes were like Japanese prices. You know, you'd pay $30 for 1 or 2 episodes of a show. That was rough.
Yeah. Oh yeah, that was terrible. Yeesh. I was just using it as an example, so-called. I know it's not worth that much.
Here we have some nice particle effects, which is another Xbox 360 thing that you wouldn't have seen prior to that. Lots of grass. The grass doesn't look good by modern standards, but I think at the time it was pretty neat. You know, it's waving around and stuff. The very farthest background is kind of blurred. I forget what the term for that is. But a lot of visual detail. Pretty lush. Still pretty because of the art, you know, the artistry. Like I said, I don't like the actual creature designs, but otherwise, artistically, it's a very solid game.
Yeah, it looks really good. It's got, what is that technique? Yeah, I know the one you're talking about where it blurs the background. Basically, the background is actually just one big texture that they put on a 360-degree sphere. Mm-hmm. So that way. Because that way they don't have to render it. They just stick it up as a picture in the background.
That makes sense. And they can control how much in focus it is.
Yeah, exactly.
So you guys, I think we need to wrap things up. I want to thank everybody for joining us on the stream. Be sure you're following both Windows Central and EastX Twitch if you're not already. Please be sure to leave a comment on tonight's article about